Without further ado, let's dive into my Notion workspace.
So eventually by the end of the series, we'll want to have a habit tracker that goes into a daily planner like this. As you can see, I kind of have a nice little list view of a daily habit tracker. But if we go into my actual full-fledged habit tracker, it takes a bit of work to get there. So if we see this, we can see, oh my God, there's a bunch of stuff. What the heck is this? Let's showcase to you guys how I get this to happen. And it's kind of a kind of takes a little bit of work, but it's worth it. It doesn't take an immense amount of work, and I can make it quick for you guys. So let's dive right into this. So we're back at the Notion homepage that we always keep making into. So let's do a little slash page. I think a checkbox would be good. Do a habit tracker. And as per usual, let's make this bad boy full width and make slash table. And make it, or calendar, and make it inline. Do a habit tracker. And if you want to add an emoji to that one, add something like this, and you're good to go. Now importantly, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go here and take a block from the bottom, drag it to the top, go back, make sure this guy is nested into this corner of things. Copy the link, do a little emoji here, so check, then paste that link into the synced block, copy the synced block, paste it into the top of this habit tracker, paste and sync, and if we want to give some extra space, you can drag another block from the bottom, and it'll go in between. All right, let's get into talking about what exactly I had for my calendar. So first and foremost, you need to create your habit tracker in a way and that has the different kind of habits that you want to build. So my habits were journaling and replying to comments. Now yours are going to be different. So if you want to have whatever it is, it's going to be simple and easy enough. So I recommend that you make a few just templates. I'm a big templates guy. It's nice and quick and easy to use. So if we take something like all right, let's do journaling, push-ups, and reading. All right, like reading for 30 minutes. So we're going to be a date, right? That's perfectly normal. We're going to get tags. So we can do like, I don't know, reading, exercise, and then journaling. Get a few different colors going. Then we can add a status box, which is very important here. Gonna make sure we want this. I like to call it status, not sure why. So let's get the dates taken off here. Let's create a template. Let's do reading a book. So just reading books here. Reading tags would be reading. Then you can make the same templates. For example, if we wanted to make more, let's do this real quick. Flex is usually a good one for push-ups. Push-ups. Then we make another one. Journaling. Make the writing one. Kind of building on the last video that we did, right? And then in the properties here, let's just have it showcase the little status box and that's it. So what we can do now in order to get the habit tracker built is we're going to have to do something that's kind of interesting. So first and foremost, you want to take something like reading and put reading here, and very simple. Basically, you're going to duplicate this as many times as possible. So what I like to do is duplicate it in. So there's only a few days in this calendar, but duplicate as many times and then highlight them all. And there's going to have that copy of, and then right-click it, edit property, edit name, and then you delete it from there. And I'll show you how to do this in a scale in a second. So I'm going to change this and send it to the next month. And then from this one, you can set it up for a month. So I'm going to duplicate this 6 times. And then I'm going to duplicate this 1, 2, 3. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. All right, now we can take all of these, right-click it, edit property, name, delete a copy of, and then you're set. And then you drag these, and I will fast forward through this, but it doesn't take too long. It's just pretty easy to do. So then that's how you basically for a month get your reading one done. And then what you can do is this. You can really quickly make the new ones. In order to make it easier on yourself, you can type push-ups. You can do the same thing. Now it's not as easy once you have more of these, but what you can do is do a little search, but push. And then you duplicate this bad boy, as I did before, and do the exact same process. And I'm going to fast forward through this process. So another idea I've actually just came up with, if we do a slash template button here. And if we do this very important thing, which is make a blank block there. Now, if we take this, and have one of each, so if we like duplicate one of these guys, I don't mean to do two, but duplicate one of these guys, take an extra reading, take an extra push-ups, fix this name real quick. We throw these into the template button under that blank block. Very important that we do it under the blank block. We can just duplicate these and then throw them in on whatever days that we want. So it's a nice little habit tracker template. Habits. So this is the day. This is the calendar view that I had. But if you want to see the daily view, what you're going to need to do is something very quick and simple. Just add an extra view, add a list view, hit properties, filter, add filter, date is today. And then show the properties that you want. So I would recommend though specifically, it is this checkbox. So we can kind of fiddle around with what order here. I usually like having the boxes at the end. We know the date's today, so you don't need to have that if you don't want. But this is how I kind of have the view in my daily planner. I just paste a linked database that has this. So what I do here is also I add a filter where status is unchecked. So then when you check it, it disappears. So now you can keep a nice little habit tracker in here. If you end up pasting it into the daily planner eventually, or wherever you have your hub, if you have you paste in a linked database and make that same view, you can have what you want, and it's really nice. I think it's great. So even if here, like you create these new ones, just drag it into this this view here. You can keep your daily one and just delete the extra block that existed because you dragged in an empty block, Dimitri. But that is a way that you can make a daily habit tracker in Notion. And if you add that into your normal workflow and to your usual place, you can have a habit tracker built out within Notion.
So I hope you liked this video. I think it was a good step in the right direction for those of you that are interested in getting this daily planner setup that I have going on. I think slowly but surely we're chipping away to getting to that view. I wanted to kind of build the framework around it and then kind of bring everything in. As you've seen with this series, there's all these different pages that kind of just can add on to one another in being in a daily space. You saw with the journal, I had something that can be daily there. Same with the daily highlight, as well as now with the habit tracking, it's kind of moving forward and you can see what it looks like in an overall comprehensive way. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this one and get ready for the next one. I think it's going to be the framework that I make within Notion that does my sort of recurring tasks. So if you're interested in that, stick around. With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.